Let's come up with a rule. Don't say what you won't say in their face.
Dion. His wife, too.
Oh, wait. Did he say his wife, too? No. See, one thing, I have a hunch that Deion Sanders would beat the brakes off of Charleston White. I have a hunch. I have a hunch. Deion Sanders, a former professional athlete, will beat the brakes off of Charleston White, a recovered crackhead. Wait, did I make that up? Is he a recovered crackhead? He looks like one. He looks like he just perpetually stands in front of liquor stores asking if you have any change when you're on your way out. And he knows you have change and you know you have change, but you still be like, oh, nah, man, my fault, bro. I'll get you next time. Why is Charleston White wearing a goddamn sweatsuit like my auntie at a family reunion? They be wearing matching sweatsuits and on the back of it is like Burton Family Reunion 2012. This boy is out of control. My nigga wearing a peach sweatsuit with the ugliest chain on earth. How does it look like Damon Wayans from 1993? If y'all seen Major Payne, you know what I'm talking about. Hey, damn, why is this motherfucker squinting on purpose or on accident?
If me and Beyonce had to be around each other for 2 weeks, you right, I'd get her. So he's a crip rapper, rolling 60, right?
This ball be saying the craziest shit on earth. He said if me and Beyonce had to be around each other for 2 weeks, I'm trying to figure out what scenario in which Beyonce has to hang out with somebody's handicapped uncle. Like, when did that become a scenario? Love the confidence, though. He has the confidence of an ugly, fat black woman on food stamps. I don't know where y'all grew up, but my grandma would have beat both they ass for showing up in they tennis shoes on that white carpet. That's just inappropriate. Matter of fact, that's unblack. And shout out to my Asians, because they know this is wrong. And why this nigga dressed like Chris? Look, I ain't even gonna go. See, sometimes you look at a motherfucker and there'd be too much shit to flame. So you just be silent. You just be trying to organize shit. Like, what do I flame? Do I flame these bullshit ass glasses? Do I flame this Christmas sweater? What should I go with first? Basquiat dreads? Like, what's going on?
You're interfering with me.
I
love my.
How you gonna love her and you gonna put your hands on?
Same reason you whoop your kids and tell them you love them and this is why you doing this.
No.
Y'all, you weapon. See, I don't fight fair. See, most is a pride.
Nigga, you better not fight fair. I know Ty Hookers that way more than this ball.
Yo, what are you doing?
Somebody need to beat his wife's ass. Every day he go out wearing this bullshit and she be like, baby, you look good. Like, somebody's lying to this man. His wife needs to get her ass beat. I just want somebody to catch this bitch coming out the hair salon and mollywop her ass and leave a post-it note on her so she know why they did it.
Unbelievable content for the mass.
This nigga wearing a motherfucking jersey with a goddamn necktie on. Now I'm gonna need somebody to beat his mama ass too, because a black mama did not raise you like this, ball.
And you just gonna keep it to yourself? Do me a favor, tap that red button right there. Subscribe.
How's his hat look homeless? It's like the hat itself is homeless. Like the hat had a bad childhood and grew up rough. This is strange as I don't know what. Good Lord.
And it literally takes no time. Try to see what happens.
Yo, what's good? What's popping? What it is, what it ain't, what it could be, what it should be, what it would be. Cam Newton the son, Mr. Boogie the all, here with another episode of Funky Friday. And I promise. I really do promise to give good content for the masses, but most of all, I promise to keep it funky for your asses. Now, boy, oh boy, oh boy, are we in for a treat today. Boy, I went from possibly losing it to now being on the same page, been DMing and communicating and conversating for months.
Attention blacks, conversating or conversating is not a word, okay? Attention blacks. You know, I like some high water pants. You heard me? I like some pants that ain't cut all the way down to the ankles. But what we cannot do, okay? What we cannot do is have your motherfucking high waters so high that motherfuckers can see your calves, like your whole calf muscle is visible. And pull your goddamn socks up, my nigga. Why your socks look like they done showed up to work drunk and shit all slumped over and shit, man? Pull your goddamn socks up. Pull your pants down. What the fuck is going on here?
To make any profit from a business. I thought I was supposed to be big and asking for donations. So the internet taught me a lot and it helped me to become all those things.
Okay, so he actually makes a good point right here, which is to say that working for the nonprofit sector. This is stupid. Men don't do that. Maybe a wealthy man's wife does that. Maybe an upper class white woman does that. But men do not work for nonprofits. I'm sorry. I know I broke a couple hearts just now. But yeah, man, go ahead and do what pays. You heard that from the big homie. Trying to help people. Now, that's all out. And I'll tell you why. Read my book called The Black Box. I take you through a life well lived. And one thing I learned in my maturity is that you need to have something to help people. You heard me? You got to have something to give. So before you have something to give, work on getting something, goddammit, okay? All this nonprofit is nonsense.
That you just named.
So really what I do know, and I've told you this while we were talking in anticipation to get you on Funky Friday, behind everything that you say, controversial, agreed upon, or disagreed upon, behind everything that you
but do his dreads stink though? Like, that's what I'm trying to figure out. Do his dreads stink? One is like a thick piece of dookie, one's like a Slim Jim. My nigga then went to a thrift store, bought the motherfucking Yankee baseball pants from 1928, and this nigga, he obviously bought them from the smallest player on the team. And this shit's his actual spandex. Like, those ain't even dress pants. Like, I thought those were pinstripe dress pants. Like, this motherfucker didn't fool all of us. He's wearing some goddamn pinstripe spandex capris on some New York Yankee. This is just crazy. Who told him that was cool? I am not cool with that.
We're 5 minutes into this segment, and we are already ruffling some feathers or may. Would you don't bring your shadow band ass over here to Funky Friday and get accountability. One thing I do believe in is making sure that I don't
believe shit you saying. You wearing a motherfucking fake bow tie, my nigga. For those of you who have any class, there's something called a self-tie bow tie, which is when you actually tie that motherfucker. I happen to own a few of them. I don't wear ties anymore, but I know how to tie them. This is a fake bow tie. I can see this from a mile away. This nigga is one part like Nation of Islam, one part Cat in a Hat, one part Winston Churchill.
I think sometimes as Christians, we can't have this judgmental attitude.
Was dumb as hell. Did this ball say as Christians we can't have a judgmental attitude? You sound just like the atheists and the non-believers, which is to say that everything's okay, dummy. No, the Bible has laws in it. The Old Testament, also known as the Torah, or you're talking about the New Testament. Yes, religions have laws, you idiot. Talking about don't be judgmental. And these are the problems we encounter when we let a basketball player, a football player, whatever the hell sport he played, it doesn't matter. The blacks play sports, and you let a crackhead get together, and these are our leaders. These are our heroes. Only the black American is so pathetic that you listen to the thoughts of someone who was never paid to think. Yes, a football player, most of them aren't paid to think. Even the quarterback who's running the plays gets the plays from the coach. But this is the one you want to listen to. It's true comedy right here. And then he called himself a Christian sitting on a set that's designed around pagan holiday called Christmas.
Not being unknown to your religion, I think.
Oh. The nigga Cam, the kind of nigga to not wear drawers because he don't want a panty line. And you heard me? He kind of nigga don't wear drawers, so he'll have a panty line in them Babe Ruth capris. You heard me? This nigga different, boy.
I don't
look. He might be one of them Dwight Howard athletes. You dig? I know every nigga after they saw this man retire from the league and they watched the shit he be wearing, they be like, "Yo, Brody was kind of different than when he was in the locker room in the showers. Like, Brody was like making eye contact with niggas. Like, you know how you be talking to the nigga y'all in the showers, but you ain't making eye contact and shit. You know, this motherfucker cleaning with a loofah. Everybody else in there got a rag or a washcloth. This nigga in there with a loofah."
I want to be able to grab hold to the spirit.
Yes, sir.
Most of the people who I heard.
By the way, I hate to break it to you all because I know a lot of you guys might be Charleston White fans, but you know, I got to keep it real with you all. Only fucking dumb people think the shit he says is smart. Just side note. And it hurts my heart because a lot of these dumb people just happen to be black. I mean, goddamn it. They say we got low IQ. I mean, I'm starting to believe it. I mean, if you listen to this dumb bastard and you think he's saying intelligent things, goddamn, you need to get your head checked.
Yeah, but this is where I can agree with you, but also it's for me to also admonish you to say you use your platform for
God damn, hurry up and say what you gotta say. This kind of motherfucker make your ass late to work. You trying to hear what the fuck he's saying? Your ass be later than a bitch to work. Good Lord. And why the fuck does his mustache hair look like dust? Can somebody help this nigga out? Like, this would a mustache look like. You heard me? Is dark and black is thick. I know a bitch like that. Dark, black, and thick. Anyways, but this nigga mustache look like dust. Man, go ahead, cut that bullshit off, bruh.